Well, personally, first of all, I got to go back to a story that took place maybe about 10 years ago. I attend traditional ceremonies. I follow our traditional ways. So I go to many ceremonies here in the States and in Canada. And about 11 years ago, I was at a ceremony up in Manitoba, a place called Rolling River, Manitoba, a reserve. And there an elder stood up and talked about a sickness that would come here to Turtle Island, and it would come from our yellow relatives, brothers and sisters across the ocean, and it would be a sickness that would kill a lot of people, but we were assured that they would find a cure for it.
Because I think when this all started, there was so much uncertainty about what we were all supposed to do and what mattered and what didn't matter. And was I supposed to be sanitizing boxes from Amazon?
Some of the difficulties for us were, we didn't really have the luxury of working from home. So the deputies, they answered most of the calls face to face, especially in the early stages of the pandemic, where nobody really knew a whole lot about it as it was evolving.
Early on in the pandemic, I feel like this is like something I don't know that many people can say. I lost six jobs in 1 week, and that was very interesting.
Just the biggest challenge was definitely just not hibernating all the time, like realizing that this is still reality and I still have to get my work done, like life still goes on. And then as well as not seeing people, because there's like that 9 month stretch where we didn't get to socialize and I didn't get to see my friends. And I mean, there's still like lasting impacts from that. Like
The challenge has been, staying away from people, staying away from the things that you love.
Well, at the beginning, of course, people were told to stay in their houses, not to really socialize. And here, we basically shut Grand Portage down. We closed our, of course, closed our casino, our lodge, like other communities did throughout Minnesota.
I did have questions about the vaccines when they first came out. I did not remember what mRNA was, and I kind of remembered how you make vaccines, but then the news said, oh, this is a brand new kind of vaccine. And that sounded a little sort of sci-fi and scary and weird. And so I talked to my doctor. I listened to what public health had to say. I consumed a lot of media from trusted sources to try and understand the science that had happened to make the vaccines possible because it was so fast. And after doing that, but especially with the consultation of my doctor at the clinic, I felt comfortable saying that instead of being scary, this was amazing and that we're so lucky that our government and and sort of the scientific community was able to do this for us.
Obviously, well, like I said, you have public health, human services, doctors at the clinic, staff at the hospital. My daughter's a nurse. I can tap into that resource as well. I think we're lucky that we have all of those resources in Cook County.
I've followed all of the instructions, not only from our traditional people, but also from modern medicine.
Everybody wants out of this as much as anything, and this is really our only path forwards. We got in right away and had a, I mean, it was smooth, safe, easy, and it felt good. The second shot wasn't super fun for me, but that's not for everybody. But I think it far outweighs the risks of COVID or anything associated with it, so.
Been really kind of a proud thing to see how great our community has responded.
How we've stuck together as a community, but also what we've learned as far as what's important and how to stay safe and just respect for other people as far as wearing your mask and social distancing and just keeping other people in mind. I hope that's something that we can reflect on and not forget.
We value each other more, right? Out of the whole process, we value each other and what it means to be together and what it means to be a community. And, I don't quite think my kids are begging to go sit in church still, but but there is a sense of value and we learned through it. Maybe not as aggressively as other historic survival scenarios, right? But but we're survivors too.
I hope we learn from this, and I hope that we apply that knowledge to the future, because if we don't, you know, it's going to be pretty tough to move ahead. And not only that, not only learning from this, but adapting to the new normal that we're probably going to experience.
I hope that when the pandemic is officially over, whatever that is, we can remember how we took care of one another and how our community overcame. You know, this community often sort of loudly can disagree passionately about all kinds of things because the people who live here really care about one another and care about this place. But in the midst of the pandemic, our community really came together to do what was right, to take care of one another. And I hope that that sense of unity and camaraderie can be part of how we move forward.
To get a vaccine. Not just for yourself, but for your family members and for your community and really the nation on a whole, that I would encourage people to really think about getting a vaccine and hopefully getting it.
You know, there's not much to say other than, you know, follow, listen to the people that are a lot smarter than you, and let's get out of this together.